Now we enter into the fourth week of our prep. So this is a very, very critical stage. This is what I call as a transition stage. The reason I call it as transition stage is because now we are entering from the VA part into the critical reasoning and RC part. So generally, if you go to other places, many people teach you the RC and the CR part right from day one. But I believe, and we at Bodhi Prep believe that you should first become good in VA. So once you become good in VA, you become good in reading. And once you become good in reading, then the reasoning comes into picture. So when you enter into the critical reasoning, and of course, I have said here that the daily reading should go on for at least 1 hour. That is what we had discussed in the earlier video and where to read from. Now, what to do in critical reasoning? Now, in critical reasoning, we focus on critical thinking. Until now, you have focused on how to arrange sentences, how to connect sentences. So there is not much of critical thinking. But once you enter into critical reasoning, critical thinking becomes very important. So, and this critical thinking is of great help and is of great use in reading comprehension. So you can say that critical reasoning is the stepping stone to reading comprehension. Now, what to do and how to do from the course. Let's go to the course here. So as you see here, this is the course. I will just push things. This is what we have here, right? Now, you go to critical get reading comprehension and critical reasoning course. So this is the first thing you should do. And in this, you will find there are so many things. Wonderful things, beautiful things, right? So this is what we have, all the different lessons. You have to go to the very top. And you will see that we have critical reasoning concepts. So first, you have to finish all the critical reasoning concepts. You finish all the critical reasoning concepts and then you go to critical reasoning practice and try to solve a few questions. I mean, I don't say solve all the questions, but take around 4 to 5 sets, because critical reasoning does not come directly in CAT. In CAT, critical reasoning is tested in the reading comprehension part. Nevertheless, it is good to solve some questions on critical reasoning, because that gives you a fair idea as to how to go ahead with the reasoning process. For that, you have to first finish the critical reasoning concepts, and then you have to go to the critical reasoning practice questions. There are 25 tests given. Don't take these tests don't take this question in the form of a test. You should take them without any time limit. They are in the form of a test, but the idea is to take these questions without any time limit as general practice questions. So don't put time limit to any of your practice until your fourth, fifth week. I will tell you when to put the time limit. So as you see here, we have to go to five, six sets. And once you have done 5, 6 sets, then you can go to the reading comprehension part, right? So in the fourth week of your prep, you have to focus on critical reasoning. Try to finish all the concept. Try to finish around 7 to 8 sets here. So to get a good grip on critical thinking. And once you enter into the fifth week, then we will go to reading comprehension. Simultaneously, you can continue with your reading activity, and you can solve also questions from Parajumble and Odd One Out. This is what we are planning for the fourth week. Now we will enter into the fifth week.